I have stuck my neck out for you a couple of times, and I'm not going to do it anymore. One more bad report from you, and I might just have to say to Renner, I think that he should get rid of you. Permanently.
Are you listening to me? You know the only thing I regret? I won't be in the courtroom to see your loving daughter get up in that witness box and put you away for life. Oh, I'd really like to see that. And I expect you can tell me all about it when I get back. Have fun, Desmond.
I've spoken to the doctor. He thinks it would be best if you were transferred to Wentworth General, so you'll be going
soon. Did he say if I could make the trial?
He's advised against it. However, the police have agreed to accept your evidence on videotape under the circumstances.
They won't need any bloody tape recorder. I'll be there in court. I want to see the look on her face when she gets life. I want to see it.
Oh! What the hell's going on?
You bloody thief, the dope's gone! This creep took it, but I know who ordered it.
Well, when you find out, I'll give him a medal.
Listen, I want this settled now!
You bitch! No, don't do it! You want it settled, Margo? You've got it. Go!
Desmond! There's no point trying to sort this out. We'll go straight to the governor's office. Right, you too, Gaffney. The rest of you go back to work.
I just don't understand why you keep making your lives more difficult than they need to be. Very well. Desmond, why did you attack Gaffney?
Misunderstanding, Mrs. Reynolds.
What do you say to that, Gaffney?
Don't know what it was about, Governor.
Oh. Then you admit Desmond attacked you.
I didn't say that.
You saw the attack, didn't you, Mrs. Morris?
Yes.
Did Gaffney attempt to retaliate?
Not whilst I was there.
I don't know what's got into you, Desmond. I thought you'd be too intelligent to get involved in common brawls. You're just out of solitary for scalding pain. Now you give me no choice but to send you straight back. All right, 24 hours, Mrs. Morris. You're in the clear this time, Gaffney, but you can be sure you'll be watched very closely in future.
That's good. I'll feel safer.
Thank you, Mrs. Morris. Take them out.
All right, come along.
You seem like a nice kid.
Thanks.
I'm not like the usual type. How'd you get into this business?
Hate it. Just didn't get the chance to say no.
You mean you're being forced into it?
Yeah.
Haven't you got anyone to look after you?
Well, I've got no family. Look, all I need's a plane ticket. Oh, it doesn't have to be overseas or nothing. Brisbane would do.
Yeah. Put that towards it.
All right, you can help Kean out with the potatoes, otherwise they won't be done in time for dinner tomorrow.
Can't you find something else for me to do? I hate kitchen work.
Just get on with it and don't stir up any trouble.
But why can't I go back to the laundry?
Because I've just told you you're going to work here. And you've already caused enough time to be lost in there. Go on, get on with it. Keep her up with it too, Miss Brown.
What's all this about the laundry?
Just out of blue with the so-called top dog.
How'd you go?
See any bruises, do you? I fixed it so she got sprung by Morris, so guess who's in the pound?
Yeah?
Yeah. Copped 24 hours for beating up on poor, defenceless little Margo.
Was it over?
It's
Some mug found my bloody stash. Took the lot. I reckon it was her.
You can arrange another score, can't you?
Yeah, but I've got suckers waiting for a hit today and bugger all to give them.
No, I can't lag.
I understand that, but this just doesn't make any sense. Now, I know what Gaffney's like, and she probably got everything she deserved. But look where it's landed you.
Yeah, it was bad luck you walking in when you did, that's all.
Oh, that's rubbish, and you know it.
Look, no matter what I do, it's not going to stop anyone from setting me up, is it?
If that's what's happening. Oh, come on, Myra, you're an intelligent woman. You know that coming the heavy would never get you anywhere.
Yeah, well, there comes a time in this place when you've got to show people you can stand up for yourself.
What are Ellen and Kay going to think when you find out you're in here?
Do you think I haven't thought of that?
Yes, I know you have. And I'm sorry about this. I know what you're going through with your trial tomorrow.
It's not me I'm worried about. Joan Kay. It's going to be hell for her in court. She has to get up and accuse her mother of murder.
About that little problem of yours, maybe I can help out. I've got supplies. Stash in a real beaut place, too. Followed out bar of soap, tin of talc powder.
You thieving bitch, I'll bloody nail you!
What if you got any brains? I got the dope and you need it.
So what do you want?
Piece of the action? Biggest piece?
Don't you try to screw me.
Keep your hair on, Gaffney. You need me.
I'm the one with the supplies coming in, so how do you figure that?
If you don't fill your orders today, you're going to have some very unhappy customers.
Like bloody hell, I'll just rip your dorm apart and get the stuff back.
You could. But it's not there. Remember, you need that dope to help you make it to top dog. Me as a partner, you get there a lot quicker.
What if I just tell you to get stuffed?
I'll clean up on my own and make you look like a mug. So what'll it be?
Okay, we deal.
Anything about Myra?
Oh, no, Jude, no. Reckon she got the pound for sure, but...
Mrs. M's not stupid. She'd know what Margo was up to.
Yeah, well, stupid or not, she still has to tell Mrs. Reynolds what she saw. And Margo would have made sure that she only saw what she wanted to see.
Yeah, she's a rotten mongrel, that Margo. She's always getting people into strike at Barnhurst, too.
Yeah, but then Reno will have her record. She'll know it's not Myra's fault.
Yeah, well, fault or not, she was still caught in the act. And even if Mrs. Reynolds thinks she was set up, she still has to do something about it.
Yeah, well, I can't wait to get out of this place. It's going from bad to rotten. Can't even get a giggle out of it anymore.
Well, if it keeps you out of here, then it's something, isn't it?
Yeah. Talking of giggles, I wonder how Pixie's going at her trial.
Oh, they won't know what's hit them by the time she's finished with them.
Poor old Pixie. You know, there is something really bothering that girl.
Ah, seems all right to me.
No, there's something really that's on her mind. I wish I knew what it was.
She's been off her tucker because of the trial. Now, you mark my words, Jude, she feels right as rain from now on. Mrs. Morris nearly cut you off.
Judy, this is Diana Hardy. Show the ropes, will you? Now, I know there's a go slow on. This is more like a dead stop. Now, you've got to do something.
Oh, well, it's a bit hard when you've got to kick the press back into life, Mrs. M.
Well, the repairman will be here soon. Then there'll be no excuse, will there?
Well, this is Doreen.
Hi.
Yeah, I'm Judy. That's Chris over there.
Hello.
You've worked in the laundry before?
No.
Well, don't work too hard in this one. We're on a go slow.
Just pretend you're a public servant.
Yeah. How long do you get?
I don't know yet.
What do you mean you don't know? You must have got something. How long do they give you?
I really don't know. I haven't been tried yet.
What?
I was remanded at Wentworth Court this morning.
Well, if you're on remand, you shouldn't be in a uniform. I mean, hell, you don't even have to work if you don't want to.
I would have thought Desmond had had enough trouble without getting herself put into solitary.
Well, that's an understatement. I'm furious. I'm sure Gaffney must have pushed Myra into that little setup. But what can anyone do when they insist on this no-lagging rule?
Oh, well, pushed or not, it's still a pretty stupid move by Desmond. I don't know, you'd think she had more intelligence after the pain incident.
Not sure that wasn't engineered either.
Oh, come on, Meg. You sure you're not letting your friendship cloud your judgment a little?
Oh, I don't know. Perhaps you're right. Well, who's house hunting?
No one. I'm just checking the prices of houses in my area. They seem to be fetching quite a bit at the moment.
Who's hoping they stay out there for you?
Desmond's solicitor's arrived, Meg. Would you fetch her, please?
Yes, of course. Is the PA on the blink again?
Yes, and let's hope the workmen get the gremlins out of it sooner. It can go right back where it came from.
And aren't you glad Joan's not around to hear you say that?
Joan and her father will be in Sydney by now. I hope everything goes well for him.
Yeah.
Something wrong?
Oh, no. Look, now that I am back at work full time, would you consider reinstating me?
Well, look, don't worry, I haven't forgotten it. But would you mind waiting for a week or two? Just to give you a chance to get right back into the swing of things.
Okay, fine.
Damn that thing.
The facts look pretty damaging.
Depends what you call facts.
Well, there'll be the police evidence. Your daughter Kay will have to testify that she overheard you threaten your husband.
Oh, come on, that was just
a
figure.
I know it wasn't meant, but convincing the jury is not going to be easy in light of other evidence. This Payne woman, for instance.
That bitch.
Yes. Well, it would have been helpful if I'd known she was going to be a Crown witness.
It's your job to find out who the witnesses are.
You're not making my job any easier. This trouble between you two was supposed to be kept from the jury. I'll be surprised if the prosecution doesn't find some way of making use of it.
Well, then it's up to you to make sure they don't use it.
I can assure you.
You seem to have already found me guilty. Whose side are you on?
I'm trying to be on your side, but you're making it very difficult for me to help you.
In case you hadn't noticed, things are rather difficult for me too.
Then don't make things more difficult. Frankly, I was appalled to find out that you got yourself into more trouble and even been confined to solitary.
You've got no idea how things work in here, have you? Both times I've been in trouble, I've been set up.
Well, in that case, speak up for yourself. Tell the governor what's going on.
That is called lagging. And any prisoner who lags is damn lucky to even make it to their trial.
I'll do the best I can for you.
You'd better smarten up your act, kid.
I'm doing me best.
Yeah? Well, it ain't good enough. Well, it's no use standing around till some John gets up the nerve to put the hard word on you. You've got to start hustling.
I don't reckon they'd mistake me for a nun, do you?
Just to get after them. You're costing more than you're worth.
G'day.
You, up the time?
Yeah, going on 10:30.
Ta.
You doing anything special? Well, no, funny business. I just want to have a look around the cross. Could do with someone who knows it. How about it?
Why not? I got some time up my sleeve.
Yeah? Oh, great. Well, what's your name?
Bobbie.
Hey, Bobbie. Jack Gordon.
Pleased to meet you, Jacko.
Let's go then.
Doreen, I heard of lying down on the job, but that's ridiculous.
And who was talking about being a public servant?
They work sometimes, don't they?
Mm-hmm. Oh, g'day, Dor. I'd get up if I was you. Mrs. Powell's coming.
Oh, God.
Okay, here it is.
Oh, hi.
That's enough out of you. Oh, well, I can see no one's breaking any union rules. However, go slow or not, you should be a lot further along than this. Get on with it.
Mrs. Powell, Diana has a little problem here.
What?
Well, they've made a mistake. She's only on remand.
Well, she must be pulling a swift one, mustn't she? Otherwise, she wouldn't be here.
I'll be blowed. I was remanded this morning.
It is not a good idea to put things over on the officers, Hardy.
I'm not trying anything. That's right. Look, she doesn't even know the procedures.
Who inducted you?
Mrs. Morris. Please, will you do something about it, Mrs. Powell?
Right. While I'm gone, though, do tell Hardy what'll happen if she is trying to put one over. Keep your hands on the folding. Mrs. Ward will be right in to see that you do.
Now, do I look like the type of girl who'd like to rape a good-looking gentleman like yourself?
Hell, Margo, if I'd known you were that harder.
Thank you.
out, your name is Sandra Louise Mason, is that correct?
You can't possibly have forgotten already.
Just answer the questions, Pixie.
Mrs. Norris, please.
Oh, go ahead, I can wait.
What is it? There's been a mistake with a new prisoner brought in this morning.
Hardy? But I put her through myself. What's wrong?
She's supposed to be on remand.
Well, I'm sure she's been convicted.
No, I checked the papers myself. Look, don't worry about it. I'll sort that. You finish, Mason.
Right, where were we? Oh, we've just established who I am.
Oh, good. All right, you're serving a sentence at Wentworth for bigamy, and you've just been sentenced to a further 6 months for escaping from lawful custody. Is that correct?
Yes, and I think it's dreadful. The judge wouldn't even listen to me.
Thanks, and good luck.
Bye.
Sorry. That was Parker's family. Apparently, a brother's seriously ill.
Oh, poor case.
Yeah, I have to stay here in reception. Can you make sure she gets a message after you've put Mason through?
Yes, yes, of course. I'm sorry about that other business. I just don't know.
Don't worry about it. I'll fix it. Be all right with her. She'd confuse anybody.
Yes. Righto, Pixie. Come on. Put your possessions on the bench here.
Oh, it's just not fair, Mrs. Morris. When I told the judge that a person in his position ought to be more understanding, he said the most dreadful things to me.
Yeah, just wait till your monthly is that, eh? We'll end up on the mantelpiece between a Tassie calendar and the picture of the old man at Surfers. Yeah, we've got a farm up near Gunnedah.
Oh, better than Sydney?
Is it ever? Hey, how about we get some lunch?
Oh, I'd love to, but I can't. I've got to get back to work.
No, that's a pity. I've got a bit of time to kill before I get back to the job.
What do you do?
Strap her at Ranwick. Well, you know, exercising the races and all that. Start around 5.
In the morning?
Yeah. What time of the day too, Margo? What's your line of work?
I'm a waitress.
Yeah? Well, where do you work? I can call in for a cuppa sometime.
No, I don't think so. But I work through an agency and I don't always work at the same place more than once.
Ah, well, I suppose I better be going. Yeah, I suppose. Well, thanks for picking out the T-shirt for my younger brother. I reckon he's King Dick with that on.
Hope he likes it.
He will. Well, I'll see you.
See you, Jacko.
Oh, but it's just so traumatic, Mrs. Morris. As if anyone would believe that I would do such a thing.
Yes, all right. Now hurry up or you'll miss out on your lunch. Mm.
Not much.
Couldn't you talk your way out of it?
I don't know why you're so pleased. If they won't believe me, what chance have you got?
Hey, Mrs. M, can I make a phone call this afternoon? It's really important.
Right, I'll arrange it. How'd you go?
Oh, terrible, Jude. It's totally destroyed my appetite.
What happened?
Well, the judge said he wouldn't listen to anything I said.
Geez, yeah, they're funny like that sometimes.
Do you know, he actually believed that I asked someone to send me that wedding card after I escaped?
Oh, he did.
He did? Now, why on earth would I want to do a thing like that?
To back up your story, Pixie. Geez, you're a worry sometimes.
But why would I want to fake Mrs. Powell's handwriting? I mean, well, that would just be dishonest.
Yeah, but the judges aren't used to dealing with people that are honest, are they?
Oh, he's just a silly old man, and I told him so.
Oh, good picks. I bet he loved that.
He was quite rude to me, actually. Mm. He actually said that he would hold me in contempt if I didn't stop talking to him. Do you believe that? I try to help him, and he thinks I'm contemptible.
Hardy, report to me as soon as you're finished.
Have I done something wrong?
No, not that I know of. You've just been transferred.
Alice, what the hell's going on?
Well, I'm sure if the governor thought it was any of your business, she would have let you know.
Yeah, but that girl has been messed around ever since she came in here.
Eat your dinner.
I know what it is. They want to get rid of you because we know that they messed up your induction.
Yeah, there must be a mistake in your papers, but it's not like Mrs. M to bugger things up.
Well, you probably had the same judge that I had. He's obviously making mistakes with everybody.
problem.
How about it?
How about what?
You know it.
Yeah, I know. How much dough you got?
$13. You can have it all.
What are you, the last of the big spenders?
It's all I've got.
Stiff kid. Tell you what. Go and buy yourself some lollies and go back home to your mum.
Now listen, honey, I want to have a talk with you.
I'm all right.
Can I tell you why? You didn't eat a thing at lunchtime.
I couldn't, Jude. It all just came in on me, the trial, my extra sentence. I'm never going to get out of here.
Look, I know how you feel, but it's not all that bad.
It's worse. It's terrible.
No, it's not. Your parole's gonna probably come up in a minute. You got your work record to back you up. And that extra sentence won't mean so much.
I hope you're right.
Of course I'm right. How about a cup of tea, huh?
Good idea.
Yeah. Anyway, kiddo, you gotta look on the bright side.
You could have ended up with Ralph.
You're lucky he turned out to be a louse, huh? Now, what have I said?
I'm all right, really.
No, you're not, Pixie. There's something bothering you. It's not just the extra sentence, is it? No,
I'm okay.
Is it Ralph? I mean, maybe it would help if you talked about
him. Look, I don't want to talk about him.
Righty-ho, let's have your dirty teeth out. Catch. Easy one. I used to play a bit of footy with my brothers.
Hey. Got a tissue?
Yeah, don't use them.
Parker must have missed these. I'll take them to it.
Sure, that's all you need?
Yeah, just the way.
Who's that?
Jeez.
Yes. Percy, you all right?
Oh, jeez, Jude, someone's put something in my eyes.
Here, do you know what it was?
Oh, Mrs. Morris, no, I don't have a clue, but it stings something awful.
Well, I'll take her along to Sister Kelly.
Yeah, what about pick up a stick?
I'll do the pickup, don't you worry.
Come on, you come with me.
Hey, it's a rotten thing to do, Mrs. Morris.
I just can't believe Mum would do that to you.
Well, then you're as stupid as you look. She killed Bill, didn't she?
Well, didn't she?
Yeah. She said she'd do the same to me. That's one thing about your mother. She keeps her word. Too bloody bad it means killing people, eh?
But you'll be all right.
Yeah. They already told me I'd be scarred.
Do you know what that means?
Some life, huh?
Can't they do plastic surgery or something?
Oh, big deal. I still look a bloody mess. Anyhow, what you been doing?
Nothing much.
Been going out?
Yeah, a bit. I've left home. I'm not seeing Alistair anymore either. I've been going out with a whole lot of other guys. It's much more fun than seeing one.
Yeah, off your bloody luck. No guy's going to be looking at me anymore. I'm going to get Myra for what she done to me. The only thing I could look forward to now is nailing her at that trial.
But you don't know that you'll be scarred. You could be okay. Anyway, I'll always be your friend, no matter what.
Stick your friendship, you stupid little bitch. I wish I never laid eyes on any of your family. Now get out of here.
He's given you enough, hasn't he?
Well, he's cut out a few, thank heaven.
Oh.
I rattled when I walked for a while. Damn thing.
I'll fix it.
Oh, I'm sorry. This arm's as good as useless. I get very frustrated with it at times.
It'll come good. Do you want another cuppa?
No, thank you, Joan.
I wonder why Dr. Webster referred you to this specialist. Couldn't he have handled the treatment himself?
Oh, he wanted to make sure, I suppose.
Yeah, I suppose so. Come on, let's get going.
Oh, I'm not looking forward to these tests one little bit.
At least we will know that everything is all right.
No, it's not that. It's just that they could take hours, and we don't want you standing around all that time.
Oh, come on, look, we've already been through this. I'll wait till the tests start, and then I'll go away for a while. I thought I might visit an old friend.
Oh, good idea. Anyone I know?
No, someone from a long time ago. But I'll be back in time to collect you.
I'm so grateful you came, Joan. I just wanted you to know that.
Oh, Joan, where's Cass? Ruth told us something was up.
Yeah, something's up, all right. Somebody used this to put pepper in Cass's eyes.
Well, is she all right?
I don't know. She's with Sister Kelly, but thank God it was just pepper.
Yeah, why would anyone want to do that to Cass? Hey, I reckon we could find out who did it. Whose hanky is it?
It could be anybody's.
Hasn't it got any initials on it?
No, Miss Sherlock, it hasn't. This is your ordinary low-class culprit, no monograms.
Well, I reckon we could still find out who did it.
Yeah.
Just give it to me.
What for?
Watch and learn.
What's all this about?
We've got a lead on the Mitchell girl and Sonia. Renner's holding him in Sydney. So I'm flying up on the 6 o'clock.
Have they got cops in Sydney anymore?
Maynard wants me to handle it.
You're supposed to be lying low. Why are they sending you to do a job the New South Wales boys can take care of?
Look, this is off the record. But it was fellows who set up Sonia's escape.
Why?
Well, we're not quite sure. We figure he might be trying to set me up.
Because you're moving in on his Melbourne operations?
Yeah. So Sonia's the bait.
And bloody Maynard's going to let you walk right into it.
He knows I can handle it. And it's the quickest way to get them all out into the open.
And did he mention the promotion he'll receive if you nail them for him?
But what about me? I'll probably get promoted too.
Right up to the pearly gates. But you know the way these blokes work as well as I do. I saw Colin Powell's family blown to pieces.
Yeah, I know. But I figure I'm in the hot seat anyway.
So why make it easier for them? It's Sonia, isn't it?
Look, she's in a lot of danger. And probably doesn't know how much. So if I can get her out, I will. Look, my main concern is to nail fellows. Believe me.
You're a mug. She'll sell you down the river without batting an eyelid.
Okay. Look, I might need your help.
Yeah, sure.
Any information I get, I want you to give to Maynard personally. Not on the phone. Can you do that?
Right.
Thanks, mate. Well, I'll see you soon.
Hey, Eddie. Good luck. Watch your back, eh? perfect. Poor Libby couldn't mix a good martini. Always too sweet or too watery.
She must have had some talents.
And some failings.
Like stupidity.
Precisely. She was no match for you.
I noticed. Don't worry, I can handle it.
It's done.
What do you mean?
Don't bother with that. They don't know a thing. No witnesses, no motive, no Libby Blake.
Why? She wasn't dangerous.
She was stupid, that's dangerous.
Oh, there you are. Sorry, but I got to the hospital and you'd gone.
Oh, don't be sorry. I couldn't be happier. The tests took no time at all.
Oh, that is good. Bought you a present.
Oh, good. I love surprises. Huh? Here. Very stylish.
Do you still wear them?
Certainly. Thank you, dear. What do you think?
Very nice. Would you like a cuppa?
Yes, thanks. You, found your friend?
Yeah. It was actually an ex-prisoner I knew in Brisbane.
Oh, that's very commendable.
In what way?
You're continuing to take an interest in her.
Yeah, well, today was more like a farewell, really.
Yes, it's sad saying goodbye to friends.
Yes.
Look, I think we should have dinner at a bright, crowded, noisy bistro. We could both do with some cheering up.
No, thank you. Not tonight. I couldn't.
Of course.
Door, what's the big rush?
I'm gonna nail the one who gave you the pepper treatment.
Oh, yeah, now you're gonna do that.
You see. Now, here they come. Just act like nothing's happening.
Nothing is happening, Door.
Jeez, Cass. Hey, has anyone here seen Jude?
She went back to her dorm.
Oh, damn it. I wanted her to see me in action.
You're not in action, Door.
Give it time, Cass.
What's the matter with you, Tubby?
You gave Cass the pepper treatment.
What?
Well, that's your hanky, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, I put it over that chair just to see who'd pick it up.
Listen, Einstein, do you think I'd touch it if I was the one who did it?
You're probably trying to put me off the track.
Bit late. You're already off the track. I think you made a mistake, Dawn.
You reckon? Get the door.
Oh! Go for it! Oh! Oh! You...
Mr. Manning. Well, what's going on in here?
Oh, Marilyn Monroe just got knocked off by Joseph Cotton. You should have heard her yelling her tits off.
I did. Turn it off. All right, you've only got one more hour in here.
How come?
Governor's orders. Early lockup for the next week.
Oh. Why?
Because of the attack on Parker.
And Cass too?
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
Oh, well, that's terrific, isn't it? She gets punished because some joker beats her up. I love the logic.
Yeah, good thing you didn't go blind. You would have copped solitary.
Just keep it civil for one more hour. Can you do that?
Yeah, suits me.
No, you're not going anywhere. Now, isn't there something that you should tell us?
I told you I'd find out who did it.
Pig face here needs to change her profession.
Don't let her get out of it. She did it all right.
And how do you know?
I know how she thinks. Just the sort of thing that double-crossing sneak'd do.
You bitch.
How do you know me?
Well, you and Sonia are a couple of popular girls. Now, come on, sit down. I could be your lucky break.
Yeah?
Fellows is a nasty bloke to get caught up with.
Look, I've got nothing to do with fellows.
Look, we know all about the escape, everything.
I had nothing to do with that. They wanted Sonia and they got me too.
I know.
You on the level?
Well, we were figuring along those lines. Now, what else do you know?
Look, they're pretty tough guys. If I crossed them, they'd kill me.
Look, I know just how you feel. But come on, give. You've got a better chance with us.
Well, it was set up with some guy named Renner.
Kurt Renner. I know him.
Yeah, well, this Renner set Sonia up.
What do you mean? For what?
Well, what do you reckon? For himself. She's got it bloody easy. I'm turning over 20 tricks a day for the sickest pimp in the cross, and all she has to do is keep Renner happy.
All right. Look, just give a copy of this to Sonia, will you? It's for an emergency.
Stevens, hey, you're Sonia's husband.
Just tell her that we're going to get her away from Renner. You too.
Supposing I can't contact her? They're watching us like hawks.
Just try, but don't take any chances. All right. And remember, we're watching you too.
Okay.
And just to keep the book straight. Yeah.
Might turn out to be the hardest money I've ever earned.
Good luck.
Something.
You leave it to me. I'll talk to them. It'll be all
no,
right.
No, don't. They've been calling me terrible names. I'm scared.
Well, I'm not. Now, I'll look after you, Audrey. No one will hurt you.
Audrey? Audrey? Oh, God, no.
Audrey? Audrey! Oh! Why?
Why? Oh, my God, no pain.
Nothing to do with it.
Oh, forget it. Now you set me up. I can give it to you step by step. I had that handkerchief with me in the kitchen yesterday. You pinched it, used it, and planted it, right?
Well, what about Burns? Wasn't my idea to belt you up. She gonna get off?
Oh, by a long shot. Watch.
What do you want?
Just smile. Keep still. Unless you've got another couple of weeks in here. Now remember, you're almost out of here, pig face.
Wouldn't be smart to start with him. What'd you do that for?
Same reason I'm doing this.
Oh.
Cheer up. Marriage is good for you.
She want satisfaction.
Oh, I can't get no. Oh God, I think they put alum in this. Oh, I don't know how you can eat it.
Barely touched the sides, did it, Cass?
What do you want this?
Yeah, that's just what I want.
Queens, what the hell?
Oh, Mr. Manning, I'm sorry. Oh. I'm sorry, Mr.
Don't
Manning.
Leave it. Oh. Just leave. Leave it.
What are you going to do now?
Well, I'm going to clean the uniform, and I'm going to write a report.
Oh, on me?
You guessed it.
He's going to put me on a charge. I just know it.
Oh, but you're almost out.
Yeah, almost, but not out.
Oh, well, I don't think he'll do anything. He's got a sense of humour.
He wasn't smiling.
Yeah, well, would you if somebody spilled porridge all down your front?
Well, I didn't actually see her hit him. She came on him like a mad bull. Figured it'd be safer to get out of there. Looks like I was right, eh?
Objection. If you were not in the room, you cannot testify that it was self-defense.
He just pushed her too far.
Ah, I will concede that. And in a moment of anger, the accused attacked and murdered the deceased.
But he pushed her to it. You don't know what he was like.
That will be all.
But he was going to bring glory back to live.
That will be all. The mate, please, Your Honour, your witness.
It was very silly of you to call me in the first place with Renner breathing down my neck.
I'm sorry, but it's important.
Nothing's that important. God, he can't stand you at the best of times. Why don't you just stay away?
Look, I know all that.
Mrs. Stevens, Mr. Renner wants to see you.
Shut up and I'll have it.
Oh, and tell Sean to keep an eye on that other Sheila.
Will do.
That little tramp's taken up too much of your time. What did you talk about?
Nothing important.
She seemed agitated.
Yeah, she heard a newscast about us. She was a little jumpy about being picked up, that's all.
It's a possibility. Maybe we should get rid of her, eh?
Yes. I've been thinking we should cut the street rackets altogether. Concentrate on the parlors. They're more efficient, easier to control, and much better profits.
Calculating brain eels never stops, does it?
What do you think?
I think that sometimes you're too ambitious. You've got a sort of a possessiveness towards my business affairs.
And were the police called after the event?
No, before. Well, I wanted them both out of the house. Bill was drunk, he wouldn't go, so I told Alan, my son, to go and get the police.
And what occurred then?
Well, he kept having goes at me.
Your husband?
Yes. He accused me of not being a woman, of being useless. He said he was going to bring her there to live, that he was going to live with her in my house. He kept abusing me. He kept saying that she was everything I wasn't.
Why did you hit your husband, Mrs. Desmond? Mrs. Desmond?
He kept coming at me. I thought he was going to attack me.
When you entered the room, what did you see?
My father. He was on the floor.
And the accused?
She was near him.
Would I be right in saying that when you entered the room, you saw your mother crouched over the deceased, holding a broken bottle? Please answer the question, Miss Desmond. Was the accused holding the bottle? Yes or no?
Yes. Mum, sorry.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare.